How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? So it's finally the weekend. We finally have our rate up increase on the AN-94 and AK-12 T-Dolls. And if you can't tell from this in the opening screen here, I have actually finally gotten my hands on the elusive 5-7. I tried so damn hard to farm her in the last events, and I did not. I just kept coming up dry, and I am happy to announce that I was able to get 5-7 after, I think it was like 8 or 9 runs, it feels like we're checking right now, so I'm going to tell you exactly how many runs it took me to get my hands on 5-7. She just dropped nice and easily. I was so fucking happy to get her. I may try to get dupes while I'm here, but I don't care enough to try to aim for dupes is the real question. Not question, but the real fact of the matter. So yeah, 10 attempts. 10 attempts was all it took. So that was good. That was a good fucking drop rate on her. I was going to talk about my multiple goals for the Singularity event as well during the video that I made for Girls Frontline here, so we'll go ahead and just highlight it. So we also have these boxes going on during the event. I have actually pulled everything here from random number generation except SAT-8 and IWS 2K. I don't care as much for IWS. She may be really good, but I care more, if I had to pick one of the two, about SAT-8 because she is like one of the two highly desired and sought after shotgun girls for SGMG, you know, comps for late game, because I believe her ability is shields for the front line, which is pretty fucking mean. And then the other T-Doll makes it, KSG is the other one, which I believe it's evasion and armor up by a large chunk for a set amount of time, which is really fucking good. So yeah, like I said, I want SAT-8. She's going to be a really good shotgunner if I were to go ahead and set her up for these boxes. Ballista comes at the 777th box, but I already pulled her, so I don't really care to get any more. And as for the actual, like, Singularity stuff going on, unless it just doesn't ever pop up here. Yeah, no, never mind. It's not even showing me anyway. I've pretty much pulled everybody that I want to pull. Maybe MP7, but none of the other T-Dolls really, like, stand out that I want. But what our prime importance is for today... Oh, the other goals as well was the neural thing, the neural upgrades, but we'll go into that in a bit. So what we're going to try to do today is try to pull AK-12 and AN-94 with as many T-Doll contracts as it takes. I don't care if I exhaust pretty much all of them, except for like maybe 5 to 10, somewhere about there, because I still need to get my daily stuff in. Hence the reasoning why these have already been made. I started these before I started work today, and here's the funny thing about it is, the first pull I got was AK-12. So, the first thing that I threw into the gacha today pulled me an AK-12, so hopefully we have decent luck with AN-94 as well. And we'll go ahead and just, Barry, cue the speeding up thing to possibly Benny Hill theme, who knows. We got a Type 95, which I think I actually do need another one of her to be able to upgrade Type 95 to a 3-stack. And then another 416, that's good to have another one. I might consider using her in my damage comp. I think she's a damage AR, I might be mistaken. So, alright, that was cool, but not what I need. Well, alright, we are down to our first needing to burn through all of our T-Dolls that we have here, so I guess I max out FNC. I brought her up to a 5-stack just yesterday for fucking funsies. The reasoning why I'm doing the method that I have, by the way, guys, if you're wondering why I'm not just immediately completing them, I can actually see what the times are when I don't do that, which I like that. There's a little less ugly anticipation behind it all. I don't really... Nah, we'll upgrade Zass. 411 is something good that I've been aiming at. I think that's K2 or K11. It is K11, and it is not what I was aiming at. But K11 is a nice addition. I'm gonna do a thing here, ladies and gentlemen, where I swap some characters around from other echelons, because if you can't tell from my grenade launcher team that I have here, I do need to swap. I want to get FAMAS to become a 4-stack, so I'll be using 2 FAMASs. And I have 2 K11s now, so I can get K11 to be a 4-stack as well. And that'll be a nice little thing to do here. I don't know if I really want to care much about FAMAS, though, if I'm being perfectly honest with you. She's got an alright grenade, but, like, instead of using her, I could use ZAS-21 and increase the damage threshold that everybody takes. So, but also I have SOP-2 in here, who's really only in here for the additional damage. I mean, I know she's, like, my wife and shit, but, yeah. Fuck it, I'm gonna upgrade him. I wanna keep TAR-21, so I think we're good for now. Let us continue. TAR-21. Starting to look a little bit grim here, though, with pulling AN-95 and that kind of... Wait a minute, is that AN-94 right there? No, it is ZAS. It's not the 405 that I want, then. I think it's 409. 409, yeah. We'll be right back. this is going to be my last set of pulls that I try to do here for AN-94, and then I'm off, so... Yeah, 12 sets, so 24 contracts will put me exactly at 10 T-Doll contracts. So, that's all I can hope for. Alright, well, it doesn't look like that luck is on my side for pulling AN-94, so I will suffice with fucking AK-12 then for now, which it's not like it's completely unacceptable, like I said, but it is a little disheartening. That is probably one of my favorite weapons of all time, so it does take a little bit of a stunt on things that I would like, but I mean, I do have fucking 5.7 now. When I didn't before, and that is just amazing that I have 5.7 as it is. So, I guess I'll have to just not look a gift horse in the mouth about it, and figure out what to do with the rest of these T-Dolls here. So, aside from that, the only other thing that I really have to show you guys is the other part about the goal that I was aiming at for the Singularity event, which can really be done at any point. Singularity just simply made it a thing, which is that neural upgrade. Oh my god, you fucking cat. Oh, Jesus. But the only other thing really is just this neural upgrade, which I now have to work on for M4 to be able to get her mod 2, which gives me another special ability with her, which is pretty dang awesome. I forget what the name of the ability is, but basically when she's below a certain, or when there's a below a certain number of T-Doll units on the field, she just starts shooting rockets at shit and gets like a crazy damage multiplier during the time of her first skill. So it's pretty neat. Can't wait until I make that a thing. I can't wait until I can mod 1 and mod 2 and etc. for G36 as well if I keep her with my damage comp. So, looking really good. I just need 1,000 of these, really, and to get M4 to level 110. And that's gonna be a little bit. I think that took about 600 combat reports last time, so. On that note, guys, I'm gonna wrap up the video right here, because there's nothing really more for me to do here. I was hoping to pull an AN-94, but just going to show it to everybody around who might be wondering about fucking drop rates as well. You're not the only one suffering. Even though I pulled AK-12 on the first set on this weekend, it still kind of sucks. No AN-94, though, so take it easy, guys.